안녕하세요, 여러분. 오늘은 영화 미나리에서 제이콥 역을 맡은 배우 스티븐 연이 Late Night Show, Late Night Virtual Show에 나와서 인터뷰를 한 거를 토대로 쉐도잉 연습하고 표현 공부를 준비해봤는데요. 이번에 골든글러브 외국어 부분도 수상을 하셨더라고요. 근데 이거는 한국 영화다, 미국 영화다, 이게 딱 어느 나라 영화다라기보다는 그냥 한국계 미국인들, Korean American Society의 모습을 좀 잘 담은 것 같고요. 아무튼 바로 인터뷰로 넘어가 볼게요.
Yeah, it's been a bittersweet entire press tour of this thing. Yeah, it's been a bittersweet entire press tour of this thing. Yeah, it's been a bittersweet entire press tour of this thing. Yeah, it's been a bittersweet entire press tour of this thing. They don't know what I do, but they occasionally see me pop up on a screen here and there, so they're just kind of confused about it. They don't know what I do, but they occasionally see me pop up on a screen here and there, so they're just kind of confused about it. They don't know what I do, but they occasionally see me pop up on a screen here and there, so they're just kind of confused about it. They don't know what I do, but they occasionally see me pop up on a screen here and there, so they're just kind of confused about it.
Pop up은 뭔가 불쑥 딱 하고 나타나다는 건데요. Come up하고 비슷하긴 해요. Come up 이 단어랑 비슷하긴 한데 뭔가 조금 더 딱 퍽하고 딱 하고 나타나다는 표현이 좀 더 강하고요. 뭐 휴대폰에 알림 같은 게 뜰 때, 카톡 알림 같은 게 뜰 때도 퍽퍽이라고 하시면 됩니다.
They're just so pure and they keep you honest. But I think, you know, when we found them, they were just so locked in to the characters. They're just so pure and they keep you honest. But I think, you know, when we found them, they were just so locked in to the characters. They're just so pure and they keep you honest. But I think, you know, when we found them, they were just so locked in to the characters. They're just so pure and they keep you honest. But I think, you know, when we found them, they were just so locked in to the characters. And when we were filming, they were so honest that, you know, you can't mess up or else they'll call you out. And when we were filming, they were so honest that, you know, you can't mess up or else they'll call you out. And when we were filming, they were so honest that, you know, you can't mess up or else they'll call you out. And when we were filming, they were so honest that, you know, you can't mess up or else they'll call you out.
여기서 스티븐이 제작에도 참여를 했기 때문에 오디션장에서 아역 배우들 노엘하고 앨런을 만났을 때 어땠냐는 질문에 이런 대답을 한 거고요. 그 다음에 mess up, 이거는 뭔가를 망치다, 실수를 하다 이런 뜻이고요. 비슷한 단어로는 screw up, 이게 있겠네요. call out은 누군가 어떤 잘못을 했을 때, 잘못된 언행이나 행동을 했을 때 그냥 못 본 채 넘어가지 않고 그걸 지적하는 걸 말하는데요. 예를 들어서 she called him out for his arrogant behavior 하면은 어떤 남자가 되게 건방지고 무례한 행동을 한 거에 대해서 뭐라고 했다 이런 뜻이 되는 거고요.
They're kind of policing us all throughout the shoot, so they're aggressive, those guys. They're kind of policing us all throughout the shoot, so they're aggressive, those guys. They're kind of policing us all throughout the shoot, so they're aggressive, those guys. They're kind of policing us all throughout the shoot, so they're aggressive, those guys.
또 여기서 policing이라는 단어가 나오는데요. police는 경찰이잖아요. 근데 이게 동사로 쓰여서 police, 여기서는 policing 이런 식으로 쓰이면은 감시한다는 뜻이에요. 그래서 촬영할 때 아역 배우들이 되게 예리한 눈초리로 그거 틀린 것 같은데요. 이런 식으로 말했던 거를 말하는 것 같고요.
I regularly get, we live just to see these photos. So we try to photo dump them every couple days. I regularly get, we live just to see these photos. So we try to photo dump them every couple days. I regularly get we live just to see these photos. So we try to photo dump them every couple days. I regularly get we live just to see these photos. So we try to photo dump them every couple days.
포토 덤프는 사진을 한 번에 왕창 엄청 많이 올리는 거를 말하는데요. 인스타그램이나 페이스북에서의 포토 덤프는 한 번에 엄청 여러 개 사진을 올리는 사람들 있잖아요. 내려도 내려도 다 그 사람 사진인 거 그럴 때나 아니면 한 번에 엄청 여러 개 사진을 왕창 묶어가지고 안 올리고 있던 거를 여러 개 쫙 한 번에 올리는 거를 말해요.
No, it was a college production and then I remember I was like, Mom, what did you think I just finished? And it was like, No, it was a college production, and then I remember I was like, Mom, what did you think I just finished? And it was like, No, it was a college production, and then I remember I was like, Mom, what did you think I just finished? And it was like, No, it was a college production, and then I remember I was like, Mom, what did you think I just finished? And it was like,
여기서 college production은 전문적으로 제작된 제작사가 있어가지고 그렇게 제작된 작품들이 아니고요. 학생들 사이에서 학생들끼리 졸작이 될 수도 있고요. 아니면 그냥 학교 내에서 제작하는 그런 작품들을 말해요.
It was a liberating moment for me because I was up on stage kind of for the first time. And I was like, what do you think? She's like, okay. It was a liberating moment for me because I was up on stage kind of for the first time. And I was like, what'd you think? She's like, okay. It was a liberating moment for me because I was up on stage kind of for the first time. And I was like, what'd you think? She's like, okay. It was a liberating moment for me because I was up on stage kind of for the first time. And I was like, what'd you think? She's like, okay.
네, 여러분 이렇게 해서 오늘 인터뷰 보시면서 섀도잉 연습하시고 표현 공부하실 수 있게 정리를 해봤는데요. 섀도잉 연습은 반복해서 하시면 하실수록 좋으니까 많이 반복 연습해보시고요. 그럼 저희는 다음 영상에서 또 뵙도록 할게요. Thank you for watching guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!